back, YouTube. It is Monday, September 13th, and we are in line at Starbucks, about to get our latest pre-workout concoction.
Yep.
Which has been working great for the last couple of workouts, and unfortunately, we have not been recording, and I say we because she hasn't either.
I have not either.
But we are using, let me see if she has it available. Let me see the part one of the concoction.
Oh, I thought you were going to show my wolf.
No, not the wolf. Look at this. A chocolate chip muffin. A chocolate chip muffin and a coffee before workout.
A coffee.
Has worked wonderfully. Yes. Wonderfully. Is that a word?
Wonderfully. Let's see. I think so.
Pre-workout, that sugar is
wonderfully.
The carbohydrate in the muffin is fast converting, so it converts into fuel right away. But it is satiating enough where there's a little bit of fuel instead of like a Gatorade or something.
Oh my God, close your window, there's bugs.
And the caffeine, well, is the caffeine. So both of those things have been working really well for us until they don't. But right now they've been working really well, and since we are sitting in line at Starbucks, I figure I come on and get our YouTube series rocking and rolling. How many weeks out are you?
I am 12 weeks out.
She is 12 weeks out, and I am between 8 and 12 weeks out because we have multiple shows on the docket, but we need to get our shit right.
We need to get our shit together.
I was about to tell her, and I figured, let me just record this.
God. Like a surprise?
Do this in real time. It's not a surprise. But one of the things that I was thinking about on the way here is, We just announced that we're going to be in Miami, mid-October, which is a month from now. We have a team photo shoot scheduled at the beginning of October, and then we have beginning of November, mid-November dates set. So all these little dates are a lot easier to stay focused toward than, you know, when you do a 12-week prep. So for example, what I was going to tell her now is, like, really got to make sure that you are on top of your stuff for this photo shoot at the beginning of October. And then the week after that, we're going to Miami. And then 2 weeks after that, we got something here in Orlando. And then we've got the Miami show. Before you know it, these 12 weeks go up. So these little short-term goals are going to be so freaking awesome.
They're critical.
To stay on track. The other thing that we had stopped doing is, since we moved, our amazing gym down here is a little bit further than we'd like. For those of you who would like to know, because you got to put further in context. For a lot of people, a 15-minute drive is further. Kissimmee Muscle, which is where we train, is now 47 minutes from our house.
From our new home.
And may or may not be a big deal. It's 47 going and then 47 coming back, plus the workout time. So these workouts can turn into like a 3-hour ordeal. So that's why we were doing a lot of stuff in our garage gym. The community that we live in has a gym. We were doing that. But the truth is that environment matters. And that was one of the reasons that we considered staying in Vegas, so that we could train at Powerhouse in Vegas, because we freaking loved it there. The workout,
we're still going.
But right now we're going to finish out these preps here in Central Florida at Kissimmee Muscle.
Yes.
And that's where we're heading right now. We got a push day. I didn't record anything for a while.
I know. Yesterday I did a poll on my stories if people wanted to see workouts, and like literally everyone said that they do.
So we are back on the recording train.
Yeah.
And we're going to rock it. So it's push day. Oh, we're up next.
Shit, our turn. Wait.
Our turn. I'll be back. All right, we're back, guys. So we left Starbucks and we made it to the gym.
We did.
And just to piggyback off of what we were saying, it's really, really cool. I was going to say important, but important is not the right word. It's really, really cool when you can set something up short term that keeps you accountable to your goal. A lot of times when you start your journey, your goal may take a while, right? Like a lot of the competitors that are going to get on stage, you know, they're going to get on this journey. It's going to be 6, 7, 8, 9 months, 12 months, right? But in between that, it's very cool to have these interim things that you are getting ready for, preparing for, holding yourself accountable for, that catapult you to the next thing. Mm-hmm. Like what I was saying before, in 3 weeks we have a photo shoot set up for our team that, you know, we are going to participate in. Mm-hmm. 2 weeks after that, we're going to be in Miami. And then 2 weeks after that, it's already November. We get into the November show. There's a show on the 6th. There's a show on the 13th. Right after that, we are leaving for Atlantic City. Mm-hmm. She's got a show December 4th. Like, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Like, there's always something, right? Yeah. And obviously, you know, not everybody is going to set up a photo shoot or has a show. But you could set up different things.
Mini goals.
Or mini events that catapult you to the next thing. Maybe find somebody who hasn't seen you in a while. Like, if you've been on your journey for a little bit, find somebody you haven't talked to in like a month or 2 months or 3 months. Set up a coffee date. Watch their reaction. You know, do little things like that. Like, get yourself an outfit that, or maybe try on one of the outfits that you haven't tried on in a while, and make it a point to wear it 2 weeks from now after you've been consistent. You know, I guess what I'm getting at is, remaining consistent can become monotonous and boring because of the routine, or because you're not used to being that consistent, and your brain starts to play tricks.
Wanna sabotage.
Yeah, your brain starts to play tricks on you. But if it doesn't have to be as long as you envision because you've got something coming up, then it's a lot easier to manage the, let me make sure that I'm doing all the things that I need to do for the next 2 weeks. And then what happens is, when you get to that 2 week mark and there's an improvement, that motivates you and catapults you to the next 2 or 3 weeks, because you're building so much momentum because you saw an outcome inside a short period of time. Not your ultimate outcome,
right?
But you saw an outcome. And that is a little piece of advice that all of you can use, and you can apply at any point in time, no matter where you are in your journey, in your prep, with your goals, no matter if your goal is aesthetic, to change the way you look, no matter if your goal is performance, you can use little mini goals to catapult you to the next phase of your journey.
And sometimes the goal could also be like a certain amount of time with a specific level of consistency. Like, I know that I've had people in our program be like, you know, if I'm consistent, like I want to be for the next 2 weeks or 3 weeks or 4 weeks or whatever the case is, like, I'm gonna buy myself these 2 or 3 outfits, or I'm gonna buy myself these different weights that I want for my home gym. So it's like, sometimes the mini goal can be, instead of outcome based, like the outcome can be something like a prize that you create for mm-hmm. yourself, but the actual goal is a certain level of consistency for a certain amount of time without the interruption. Mm-hmm. I hope that makes sense.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
Anyway, we are recording this for the YouTube series.
The YouTube.
But I am sharing it with our private group on this Monday. And hopefully that serves as a little bit of juice to give you guys some insight to what we're doing and different things that you can do. But this video is a part of the YouTube series. So depending on whether or not you're watching it in our private group or on YouTube, we just got to the gym. It's go time. It is push day. We're going to record some of the stuff that we're doing today. So we'll see you on the other side.
We got through the warm up. First two moves were shoulders. Then we did a little chest and tricep. Both of them were 3 rounds and progressing in reps. Weight was the same, 10, 12, 15. Same thing with the tricep and chest. So we are 14 sets in, a couple hundred reps, and then just moved over to this side of the gym so that we could get the workout started now. And then kind of like rotate through the circuit here using the dumbbells here. Did you make it over?
Huh?
Did you make it over?
Everybody wanna be cousins. Everybody know I'm buzzing. Like Marvin's up to something. I missed my flight to LA to record this here, but man, it's nothing. It's nothing. Y'all know how I'm coming. Yeah, I'm always stunning. Yeah. It's nothing. It's nothing.
just wrapped up that push day. How was that, babe?
It was
funny great. Thing, we wanted to document more, but the gym is packed. And honestly, this is the time that we come because it's normally not as busy, but it's Olympia season, so the gym's busy. There's a lot of people working out. There's a lot of tourists working out at the gym. And we didn't record as much, but we got some of it, right? And now we're heading to get a meal. I still got another workout. We got stuff to do, so we're gonna get it done.
Here we are on our recording day.
Here we are, back in the car.
We just left Vitamin Shop.
Mm-hmm. Michelle.
We went to pick up. Oh yeah, that would be great. That's new, we never do that.
Unboxing of millions of things we like to get. Okay.
So we got some citrus bergamot. Ubiquinol.
Ubiquinol. We have another ubiquinol. Grapeseed.
Grapeseed extract. Pycnogenol.
And apple cider gummies.
For digestion. So I have full intentions on living for a really long time. So I take a variety of supplements that I feel are going to enhance and extend my lifespan. So that's what those are. They're for circulation, digestion, heart health, improved cholesterol. If you want more info on any of that, we could always set up time to chat. I am not going to post it here because that always gets messy. People say, he said, and I'm not saying anything. So there's that. But anyway, I wish we would have recorded our trip at the Vitamin Shop because it's always eventful. This one wasn't, but the person there was not the nicest.
And no.
There's no need for that. We got home, had a meal post-gym, and then the evening is filled with more activities. I've got a call in 40 minutes. Then I've got another call as soon as I hang up. Then we have our podcast at 8 p.m. And right now Junior is at karate. So we should be wrapping the day up around 9 p.m. We got some meals to consume, but luckily we were able to get our workout done without rushing, which is one of my pet peeves. I hate rushing. I hate rushing in general, but I certainly hate rushing the workout. I hate being there like, all right, we got to be done by this time.
Yeah.
It's like, what, you should have just left, right? Because you're not fully present. You're not in it. So that's where we're at. It's still Monday, September 13th. The day is young. It is 6 p.m., but the day is young for us. We still got tasks to tackle and some other stuff. So we are going to bring you along the ride today. And hopefully during the week, we bring you along. What are we doing? Tomorrow we're going to restore.
And Vitamin Lounge.
We're going to try to go get some IV infusions tomorrow.
And
we're
going
to go. We're going to go to Trader Joe's. And we're going to go to Restore. So hopefully we bring you along all of those as well, because it is our mission to share all of these experiences with you.
Yes.
So we finished a Trader Joe's run. Always an interesting experience. We should record inside, but it was really busy. And I start to do videos about calories and macros, and she's like, you make another video?
That's how I sound.
That is not how she sounds. But anyway, it's always fun to go to Trader Joe's. There's just not one close to us. So when we make the pilgrimage, we try to take advantage. The cashier really was caught off guard that we didn't get any pumpkin stuff.
I know, me too.
It's pumpkin season.
I know.
Just not for us.
Nope.
But Trader Joe Chronicles. 10 cross body on each side. You got your 10 good mornings, 5 singles per leg.
All right, guys, it's Wednesday and we are back to recording. It's 9 a.m. Already did one of these Zoom workouts, jumped in the shower, and we are gonna rock and roll today. We're gonna record the entire day. I know I shared a little bit about Monday, a little bit about yesterday, but we're gonna go through the whole day today, starting with a 10 a.m. workout right here, and then we are heading to Kissimmee to do our other workout. But we are gonna share a ton of stuff today to let you know where we're at, because we've been MIA for a little bit here, but we are back to documenting this journey. All right, breakfast really hasn't changed much, or meal one. Still doing 3 eggs. I'm doing 1.5 ounces of ham,
two slices of the potato bread, and then a little bit of cream cheese, the low-fat cream cheese. Coffee's the same. Still watching stuff on YouTube in the morning, but all of this staying the same, so I'm gonna prep this all now. All right, so here it is. Three eggs scrambled, two pieces of bread, a little bit of the light cream cheese. Look at this. It's 90 calories in 2 tablespoons, and I use a half of one. All right, so we're gonna wrap that up with some Nespresso. I do 3 teaspoons of this, measure it. This is actually number 3 today. First 2 I do with a little evaporated milk. This one is black. And this is kind of using to get off and going for the movement that's coming on now. So we just wrapped up our morning circuit. We had guests today. So any of you that ever want to come train with us, come do it. So we just wrapped that up. We are going to have, or I am going to have a post-workout shake. We're going to change. We have lunch, and then we are heading to the gym. Oh yeah, it's Wednesday, but we have to make it happen. Here is, we're going to do a scoop of Formula One and a half scoop of Ignition. We have failed miserably at scheduling and executing. So today was like almost like a do or die day. We had to make it a priority and make it happen when it happened, and almost like use it as a momentum building day. So moving forward, these morning circuits and afternoon workouts are going to be the way to go. This is meal number 2 after the shake. Watching some of that, and this is going to be a pre-workout meal today, because after this we're going to go train. All right, a little interruption to the day. I forgot I scheduled antibody tests today, so I'm going to go get an antibody test at LabCorp that I've scheduled myself, because I handle all of my blood work. I get blood work checked routinely, quarterly. I like to see where it's at. I like to see where my hormones are at. I like to see where my cholesterol is at, my sugar, all of it. I just like to know what's going on. I don't personally like to wait until someone tells me that I should check it to see what's happening, or for them to interpret whether or not what's happening is good. I like to have multiple readings at all times. So I'm on my way to get that. All right, here we are. Made it to. I gotta sign in. Wait my turn. Made an appointment, but I'm early. Never happens. All right, guys, I got that done. It was in and out. This is the best time to come and do this. And then 48 hours, I will know if I have antibodies in my system. Guys, here's a recap of the circuit that we did. It ended up being a little over 500 reps. Now we are moving into the pre-workout muffin, some black coffee, espresso, and we are gonna go work out at the gym here where we live, get this back workout. Workout 2 complete.
Finished.
A little pull to complement what we did earlier. We are on schedule. Pushed on Monday, people today, we got likes tomorrow. So got a couple of things. Sometimes this gym, it's hard to record when it's busy or when there's people in there because it's so quiet, but we got some footage.
All right guys, it is Thursday, Thirsty Thursday, Throwback Thursday, and I didn't finish recording yesterday. We actually went out to dinner after that last meal that I shared. Yeah. Found a new Mexican spot. We love Mexican food. This morning, woke up, time went really fast. 10 a.m. circuit was on point, another 500 reps. Pretty similar to the video that I recorded yesterday. Now we are Kissimmee muscle bound. It is leg day, and although I wanted to almost wrap up that Wednesday recording day, want to take advantage that we got leg day today and get some footage and share.
Yes.
And then this way the next update or the next video will have a little bit of context. So I'm going to record a little bit of footage for today and then wrap up this video, as this was our We Are Back video, and hopefully some of the stuff that we shared makes sense. If not, ask in the comments, right?
Let us know.
But we continue moving forward.
If you don't want to make waves, be mediocre. Be normal and fit in. Dress like them, walk like them, act like them, eat like them, go where they go, think like they think, do what they do. And once you've neutralized your uniqueness, you don't need courage. It takes courage to be different. It takes courage to go where you've never gone before. For some of you, it took courage to come to this conference. It takes courage to get you outside of the box. It takes courage to be successful. It takes courage to win. People don't talk about people that don't win. If you win, they're going to talk about you. Do you have the courage to stand there though the storms keep raging and the people get to talking and you stand there and say, I've come too far to turn around? Do you have the courage?
All right, guys, so we wrapped up that leg workout. Just got home, waited for that ride home to kind of just keep burning through some of that. And one of the things that I just implemented was this 30-minute walk. In addition, I'm trying to do the morning circuit, trying to make sure my step count is high. And this 30-minute walk kind of gets me there. So this is going to be it for today. And this is what we've been doing, what I've been doing this week. So hopefully there are no interruptions and circuit stays, the walk stays, the workout stays, food's on point, and we continue to move progress. But that is it for this episode. See you on the next one.